Ryan. Ryan, did you hear me? Ryan, you getting dressed?
In other news, reactions were mixed in Washington, where attention turned towards the Federal Reserve Board's surprising announcement.
Come on, we can't be late for school again this week. I mean it.
5 minutes to eight, and it's going to be another gorgeous day. High in Manhattan, near 78 degrees after...
Time to brush your teeth, now.
No need to even think about it.
It's not a monster at all, it's a Ryan. Come on, Ryan, honey, please, we're late. Can you walk a little bit faster for me, please? Look, Ryan, I'm sure that you'll feel better when you get to school and you see all your friends, okay? Well, Ryan, I guess I'm gonna have to go without you. Goodbye. Come on up. Oh, my gosh, you're getting big.
Alexandra, they found a body they think might be the missing girl. They're going to take her mother down to identify. I've got to go. She needs me.
Doc, how you doing there?
Good to see you.
Alexandra, come, you're next. She's been my patient since she was a little girl.
Let me say hi to her at least. Hi, I'm Nick Begon.
Alexandra O'Hara.
It's gonna be 20 minutes before the next one. I can give you a lift if you want.
Thanks.
That's what I... Hold on.
Let me call you back. All right.
No, it's what I do. I run a livery service. Okay? I'm going that direction anyway.
It's okay, really. I'll wait for the next bus.
Right, listen, no charge for you. Any friend of the docs is a friend of mine.
I really could use a lift. Very nice car you have.
I have a fleet of them. I rent them out to gypsy drivers. I don't normally do my own driving, you know. The customer has to be pretty special.
Doc said you were a flirt.
He said that?
Mm-hmm.
You really said that?
He said that.
I don't think of myself that way. I consider myself a very sincere person. I was wondering,
Maybe we could get together sometime if you want.
Oh, I don't really date. Thanks for the ride, though.
I thought you swore off Nan.
I did. Maybe you want to lend that one to me.
Nice car. New World Federal. Alexandra.
Okay.
This is Alexandra.
Hi, Alexandra. This is Nick Pagan.
Listen, I was wondering, you know, you said you didn't date. Does that mean you're married? Because, you know, I didn't see a ring or anything.
Nick, I have a 4-year-old son.
Oh, that's great. I love kids.
With work, you know, I hardly have enough time with him as it is.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, it doesn't have to be a real date or anything. I mean, you know, like the three of us could go and just...
It'd be nice to see you again, that's all.
Don't forget, we have a deal. I don't think so. My divorce wasn't a lot of fun. I still need some time.
All right, well,
maybe I can, you know, check back sometime or something.
Bye.
I hope you didn't throw away an opportunity that won't come around again. Like giving him my number.
Want to go to the moon?
No.
No?
No.
It'd be fun. I could rent a spaceship and we could pack a lunch.
Hi. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, I stopped thinking about you, so I'll come by and say hi.
How'd you find out where I live?
I have my ways.
Certainly are persistent.
I just felt like something clicked when I met you yesterday, and I meant what I said. When I told you I like kids, I have 2 daughters of my own. Stephanie and Gina. They're 7 and 9. She's 9.
What about your wife?
My ex-wife. She took them off to Philadelphia. I don't get to see them as much as I'd like to.
This is Ryan, my son.
Hey, Ryan.
Hi.
Can we get a handshake? Hey, Ryan, you like horses? I have a horse in Van Cortlandt Park.
I like Budge.
You like bugs?
he's a little obsessed right now with anything 6 legs or more.
Yeah, well, who isn't?
Hey, listen, I know a great place to see bugs. Have you ever been to the Natural History Museum?
No.
In a bribe, exactly. Thought you'd like them.
Thank you.
Oh, no, no, no. Look at this.
Wow.
Is that cool or what? Now, look, this guy has his ears in his front legs. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
You can?
Yeah.
And when he rubs his wings together, you know what happens?
What?
He sings. That's how he sings, by rubbing his wings together. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see that giant red parrot up there?
Yeah.
And then look, there's a smaller green one.
Oh, yeah. I want to go over there.
Okay, go ahead. What?
Yeah. I was thinking how lucky Ryan is to have such a great mother.
Well, he's the best thing in my life. Although sometimes I feel like I just, you know, I don't have enough to give.
What about his dad?
He's not around much. Do you have a great mom?
She died when I was young. My father tried hard to make it up.
Yeah. My father walked out.
Yeah, well, that's something I swore I'd never do, abandon my family.
What about your marriage? Your kids?
We were young. She left me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Mommy! Mommy, Nick! Tell me about that, the giant bird!
Well, thank you. I had a really great time.
Well, I hope it's the beginning of a lot of really great times. Listen, there's something I want to tell you.
Oh, you don't have to tell me anything.
I work undercover. I had a really good time with you tonight, so I just wanted you to...
Then you lied about deliveries.
No. I don't lie. You were the one person I would never lie to. No, it's a good cover and brings in a nice income. I I just had a really good time with you tonight, and I wanted you to know what you're getting into.
You must go out with a lot of women.
Well, I've known a few, but you seem different to me. You seem so grounded, you know, so together. I mean, like most women don't have it together.
No, that's not the way I feel.
Well, no one should have to do it alone.
I'm not ready for this.
It's okay, we'll do it any way you want.
Okay.
Well, I hope I can see you again. Good night.
Bus that went bad. Come here. This is my beeper. So one bad thing about this job, it calls me away at some strange hours. I hope you can get used to that. Hello. Yeah, I'll be there in 15 minutes.
I'll make you some coffee before you go.
You're too good to be true.
Fine, honey, go to your room and play for a minute.
Put the knife down.
You scared me.
I'm sorry, I was just trying to show you how easy it is to break in.
You didn't have to scare me.
Don't worry, I'm going to put new locks in.
Honey,
I just want to impress upon you how much you need a man around here. Ryan!
God.
Come here, buddy. I'm going to got you. Come here.
Did you learn how to break into apartments anyway?
Police Academy. Come here, sit down, Ryan. You ready for this? Close your eyes.
It's an ant farm.
Ant farm.
Oh, look at that. That's fantastic.
And this is for you. Open it. It's a wolf. You're a beautiful woman, Alexandra. You deserve to be surrounded by beautiful things.
Thank you. Nick, I can't afford this. I'm way over my head in debt as it is.
This is the kind of place you should live in, all right? And don't worry about the money, because I'm going to take care of you now.
No, I don't want to have to rely on you.
Don't rely on me. Listen, I want us to have things, okay? I want us to travel and see the world. Besides, it's a much better place for Ryan.
Wow. Never lived in a house before. I've always lived in an apartment.
Well, now you can live in a house.
Hey, Joey, how you doing?
This is my nephew Joey. This is Alexandra and Ryan.
Hi.
Give her a nice kiss. And this is Anna. Hi, Anna. This is Joey's girlfriend, Anna.
Hi, Anna.
Is she pretty?
I am beautiful.
Hey, you're finally here.
Nice to
Oh, so this is the one. Oh, and this must be Ryan.
Yeah,
hi.
Hey, Alexandra.
Hi.
I think he told us all about you.
Hi.
I can see already you're too good for him.
This is my brother Ray and Louisa, my sister. And this is Jules, his daughter. Hey, Jules. How are you? Say hi.
Hi.
This is Miss Flores and Mr. Flores. It's Anna's mother and father. Papa!
Don't worry, it's not as overwhelming as it seems.
And this is my father.
Nicholas, my pride and joy. This boy is going to bring this family back to what it once was. Is that right?
Yes, sir. Well, Pop, what do you think of her?
She looks just like your mother.
Yeah, come here. I'll show you.
See, the profile? Right, Nikki? She was so young. All she ever wanted to do was visit relatives in the old country. The biggest mistake of my life was putting her on that boat. Alone.
Papa, please. Nobody wants to hear this. This is a happy occasion.
Right. Give Alexander a drink.
Come on.
Nikki. Hey, this girl, she really wants you.
This is what I want, Pop.
Yes, well, you've always gotten what you wanted. I saw to that, and I will continue to see to it.
Quiet down, everybody. I have an announcement to make. I brought Alexandra here today because I wanted you to meet the woman I've been looking for my whole life.
Oh.
The woman that I want to be my wife.
Oh.
That is it. She'll have me.
Oh, I don't believe this.
You gotta say yes. You don't want to embarrass me in front of my whole family.
Don't let him get away, Alexandra. He's a good man.
But be careful. You get him, you get his whole family.
Hey, Brian, come here. Listen, tell your mom to say yes.
Say yes.
Well?
Yes.
I want my son to be happy, and that's all I ever wanted.
Salute.
Salute. Cheers. Salute.
Salute. Congratulations.
Welcome to the family.
Bye, son.
Thank you.
I'll race you to the door. No, I'll race you. No, I'll race you. Oh.
Mom, it's us.
Oh, my little boy. Oh, now were you a good boy at school?
I passed.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, all right, go to the kitchen. There's a surprise. Oh. Ah, he's a joy, that boy.
Yeah. Look, I got the wedding photos back.
Okay.
Here.
Thank you, Nana.
That's all right, darling. This one's for you.
One.
What'd they say at the clinic about your eyes?
Oh, they want me to have the operation, but Medicare's not going to cover it.
Well, don't worry, I'm getting you the money.
You made a beautiful bride. Not twice, huh?
Ma, why can't you be happy for me? Just because your life didn't work out, it doesn't mean that mine can't. This time it's gonna be good.
Very good.
Joey!
Joey! Hey, hey! You're interrupting here.
Nick, why are you painting the place again? I thought you had it done before we moved in.
It wasn't right. I want it right. What's going on here? You giving your little girlfriend a hard time here, Joey?
I'm not giving her a hard time. Anyway, she's not my little girlfriend, right?
Well, everybody's saying how great you two are together. I mean, look at him, Alexander. It's pretty sexy, huh? Look at these faces, huh? Of course, Joey's got a little growing up to do before he can handle a real woman, huh, Joe?
Hey, come on, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Listen, you guys are doing a terrific job. This place looks great. Here we go, pal. Let's take that out for something nice, okay? All right? Mm-hmm. All right. Let's get this place cleaned up. Very good. Now listen, I'm deep into a case right now, okay? Now I'll get there when I can.
I'll get there when I can.
You know what? I'm not going to listen to this anymore.
Why?
Nick, what are you doing?
Nothing. Hey, listen, you know what? I'm hanging up now, okay? I'm hanging up. Goodbye. And I'm going over your bills here to see what you can consolidate.
It's 3 in the morning.
I know, honey. I'm kind of wired still. I had a late shift. Can you maybe make me some breakfast or something?
Sure.
Thank you.
Who are you talking to on the phone?
I don't know. One of the drivers. Alexander, what's this? It's got $21,000 in it.
Oh, it's my father's retirement fund. He thinks because I work in a bank, I should handle it for him.
This is crazy to keep this kind of money in the bank. You should invest it for him.
Yeah, I know. But it's the first time he's ever trusted me with anything important.
And I realize that, but, I mean, the guy's worked hard his whole life, right? I mean, at least you'd give him a shot at a decent retirement.
He's an old man in a nursing home. It's all he's got in the world.
Yeah, but we can make him a lot of money. Let me invest it for you.
I don't know.
Let me invest it for you. Okay? Okay?
I don't know, maybe.
Honey, please.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Give me five. No, other side. Cut the pickle.
Tickle. Nicky, I've been calling you all over. I called you here. I called your beeper. Why didn't you call me back?
Relax. I've been around. What's up?
Man, you gotta help me. I think something happened to Anna.
What do you mean? What happened?
Well, her mother's been calling, and I guess they had an argument the other night. And Anna said she's going to go over to Gina's house, and Gina hasn't seen her. She hasn't called me. Nobody's seen or heard from her.
She'll turn up. Maybe she's over some other friend's house or something.
She would have called me first. I would have been the first one she'd have come to.
All right. I'll make a call to some friends I know, a missing person, see what's going on. Alexander, take Joey in and get him a cream soda or something.
Come on. Ryan, come on.
It's all right, Joey. We'll find her.
Stop looking for her.
So, honey, I've been all over the whole city on this thing. Eventually, she'll show up.
You know that?
Yeah, look, it fits a pattern with her. All right, she gets in a fight with her mother. She runs away, all right? It happens all the time.
No, that's not what Joey says.
Honey, I'm starting to crack here. All right, I just need a break from this damn city, that's all. The crime, all of it.
But, honey, you're a cop.
See, I'm up to my chin in it every day, you know? I mean, no matter how hard I try to shut it out, somehow it just leaks back in. You know, and there's nothing I can do to change anything. How do you think that makes me feel? You know, I'm just asking for a week, all right?
Well, I'm sure that my mother can take Ryan, but I don't have any more vacation time with her. I'd have to get an advance.
Just do it, okay? All right?
Yeah.
Love you. Mm-hmm. This is place.
Where?
You'll see.
I tell you or what? Is this a million miles away from the Bronx, huh?
It's beautiful.
You want to ride?
I'm not going to fit on a horse.
Come on,
before.
You're fine. Oh. You're with me.
Okay.
Hold on. You all right?
Yeah.
You know, I never brought anyone up here before. I wanted you to be my very first.
You know how much I love you.
How much? What?
I have to hold on.
Hold on. Ready? Hold on. Whoa.
Wow. It's perfect.
No, not quite. Open it.
Oh, Nick, it's beautiful.
Try it on.
Right here?
Yeah, that's the beauty of this place. There's no one for miles away.
All right.
We gotta go back. Joey just called. I found Anna. She's dead.
They killed my baby.
What are you saying?
And him.
I loved her.
You loved her. She is dead in that box because you loved her.
No, don't say that. That's a lie.
Miss Flores, you're upset. Please watch what you're saying around my family.
Where is your shame? You call my baby in the night. You toy with her. You tell her she should disobey her mother.
Mrs. Flores, I will not allow you to speak this way, even in your pain. No one talks about my family this way.
No, I will say it. They killed her. They squeezed the life from her, and then they come here. They think they can mourn her. Get out. I can't stand to look at you. Get out of my sight.
All right. All right. We'll leave. She's grief-stricken. But we don't have to listen to this talk. Say pazza!
No, you are the one who is crazy. You will rot in hell for what you did.
Why would she pick on you?
I don't know why, me. I mean, a woman's desperate, you know? I mean, if your kid was found murdered, wouldn't you grab it any kind of butter?
Mother said that you called her. Why would you call her?
You know what? We've been over this. I'm done with this conversation.
No, Nick, I want to finish it. And whenever things get hot, you leave. You always leave. I want to know if you called that girl like your mother said. I mean, she's saying that she's in love.
You can take sides with that crazy old woman against me? Is that what's happening here?
I won't be it. I'll leave you so fast.
Fuck out of here and you'll never see your father's money again.
You can't hold me hostage to that, Nick. I won't live my life that way.
Listen, don't I take care of you? Don't you live better than you've ever lived before? I mean, look at me. Now, listen, I'm sorry I hurt you. It's just that it hurts me so much that you don't believe me when I say things to you.
Let's talk about my father's money, Nick.
You'll get it. It's just tied up.
And my mother's money that you promised for her
operation.
You'll
get that, too. It's just so stupid for us to fight like this. You want to know if I called that girl or not? Do you want to know if I called that girl?
I did not call that girl. Okay? I mean, if there's any truth to this, don't you think the cops would be crawling all over us?
Well, maybe they leave you alone because you're one of them.
No, honey, it doesn't work like that. I'm sorry.
There's no way you can make things perfect for that kind of man. Did you know that? You do it their way and then they change the rules.
I won't let it go on.
Go on. It used to make me heartsick to watch you wait on your father when you were young. Bring his newspaper, polish his shoes. Yeah, you wanted him happy.
I wanted him home.
And you think you can hold on to Nick the same way?
He owes me money. As soon as I get it back, I'm leaving him.
That's his hold on you. You really believe that he's going to pay you back?
I'll get it back.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Alexandra.
Come on, Ryan. We got to go.
Yeah. I'll call you, Mom.
This whole thing is making me crazy. All right, listen, cops come with baggage, all right?
The pressure just spilled over. I made one little mistake. I swear to you, I will never hurt you again.
I thought I knew you.
I know you. You know me like no one ever knew me. Yes, you do. My life is a garbage dump out there. I don't want that part to touch you. I want us to build something good together.
How can I build something with you when I can't even trust you?
You can trust me. You can trust me.
Tell me you get my father's money back. I don't care about
it. I don't lie, okay? You'll get your father's money back. But things got to change around here, all right? Now, I want you to go pick up my kids with me in Philadelphia. I want the whole family there. Nice. Got it?
Hey, Jules. What are you doing? You'll be late for school.
You girls won't buy cigarettes for you.
We do lots of things, but we don't smoke.
Yeah? Like, what kind of things do you girls do? Come on, get in the car, I'll give you a ride.
Okay.
You don't pay anything for them. Then you can just come and take them whenever you want.
I got court papers, Colleen. I'm doing my part.
It's always on your trips. You always get what you want.
It's okay.
This is last time. Do you hear me?
Excuse me, Colleen. You want to talk to my lawyer?
You seem like a nice lady. Take care of my girls for me, would you? You may not believe it, with his smooth charm and the way he surrounds himself with his family, but he's real dangerous.
Alexander, let's go.
Don't cross him. Best thing that can happen to you is if he finds a new woman and moves on.
Oh, he's worried sick. Jules isn't home yet. She hasn't even called.
Yeah, she's probably with that friend of hers and forgot about the time or something.
That's what you want me to do, Nick. You know how it goes.
We can't find a missing person until she's gone 24 hours.
Oh, come on, Mario. So that's it with people you know? We gotta play it by the book?
This is my kid we're talking about.
Look, she was last seen at the school at 8:20 this morning. If she's not back by 8:20 tomorrow, then come in and file a complaint. You're not listening to me.
Hey.
Jules is not the kind of girl to run away.
Sir, we're doing everything we can, okay?
Nick, you gotta help me, man.
Well, stay over here with Alexander.
Mario.
You know what?
Next time you do
that, Nick, give me a break, man.
These cops are morons. They draw the check and they don't do nothing. And listen, I'm going to take care of this myself, okay, Ray? I've got some friends. I'm going to make a call. I'm going to find her, all right?
But you got to be my aunt, didn't you, man?
Huh? You're going to be okay.
I'm fine.
All right. All right. Get out of the way.
Okay.
Mr. Pagan.
Yeah.
Harold Shapiro, 43rd Precinct. You're the uncle, right?
Uh-huh.
I understand you were the last person to see the girl.
No, I was with my family all day. Pick up my daughters in Philadelphia. My wife is there asking me.
What we're telling you is that we've got witnesses who put you with your niece at the school
that
morning.
Yeah, no, I caught her and her friend down by the corner grocery buying cigarettes. I kicked their butts and I sent them back to school.
Do you mind telling me why you didn't say anything to us about this before?
Well, maybe because nobody bothered to ask me before. Well, Mr. Shapiro, if you'd been on top of this thing the way you should, you know there was another witness that saw her get into a black van after school. You know, maybe if you check that out, you'd find her.
We'll do that.
Good.
Mr. Pagan, nice meeting you.
My pleasure.
Why aren't you telling me you're a cop?
Can't go flashing my badge.
For another cop?
Alexander, shut up, okay? Shut up if you don't know what you're talking about, all right? Now, if I hadn't got through the commissioner's office, those two know-nothings wouldn't be on this thing at all.
Nick, answer my question.
What's your question?
Why did you tell them that you're a cop?
Listen, I'm in a dangerous position here, okay? I can't tell guys like that I'm a cop because... because I'm in deep undercover right now. I investigate other cops.
NYPD, 43rd Precinct.
Yes, I've got a badge number. I need to know the officer that it belongs to.
Is there a complaint?
No, please, if you could just give me the name of the officer. The badge number is 6375.
All right, just a minute. Ma'am, where did you see this badge?
An officer showed it to me.
Well, we'll need your name and address. We're going to send someone out.
No, don't do that.
Well, ma'am, in order for us to... Ma'am?
Hello, Miss Pagan. Is Nick here? Because we have to get a hold of him. They discovered another body. His brother's down at the morgue, and he wants Nick to stand by him while he identifies it.
By the way, we checked out that black van, but we came up with nothing.
Listen, I hear you've been calling the department about me. I don't want to hear something like that ever again, you understand? And you're messing around with things you don't understand. Just keep your nose out of it.
She was found in a garbage bag by the Whitestone Bridge. She's been dead just about a week. Oh, God.
Ma, it's me. Listen, I gotta get out of here. Can we stay with you a while? Yeah, I got him in school. I'll bring him by.
Alexander. Who are you talking to?
My mother. She's sick. She needs me.
I know you, Alexander. You're lying to me. Bring her here if you have to.
This is the way I want it, Nick.
You'll regret this. Nobody leaves me. Giving him a bath.
Why would you give him a bath? He's supposed to be... Oh, my God, Nick. Why would you do this? He's just a child.
Listen, I wanted to see Alexander. You can't leave me.
Nick, what are you doing? Just sitting there? Call an ambulance.
I'll drive. It'll be faster.
Just hurry up.
Alexander, you're going to have to tell him you were there.
You're crazy.
I told you it was an accident.
Nick, what are you doing? Keep driving.
Listen to me, all right? You listen to me. Now, why should they believe me when you don't? I'm their stepfather. I refuse to go to jail over an accident that
Nick,
was not
please.
My fault.
Nick, please, he needs a doctor.
And admit it was your fault, Alexander. You should have been there. You should have been with us.
I'll do anything, please.
Don't screw me on this, Alexander. I got friends in authority. Here's bail. You put me away, and I'll be out in 48 hours, and I swear to you, I'll get you, and I'll get you again.
I'll do anything, Nick, please. Please, just get my son to a doctor. Please. Somebody please help me. Somebody please help us. My son, he's been burned. He's been burned on his back. Can we go, sweetie? They're going to take care of you, okay? We'll slide here on your side. It's all right, honey. I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you some questions. No, I have to go with my son.
What
needs
happened
me here. He was burned.
It was an accident. My wife was bathing him, and our water's kind of unreliable.
You understand I'm going to have to call in social services.
What? Social services?
Ryan's never even had a bruise before.
Ryan!
The bad news is your husband's going to be arrested on charges of attempted murder. The good news is you're going with him.
Please, I want to call the hospital. I want to check on my son.
They can, and we'll be held against you. All this concern is coming kind of late, isn't it?
Why are you treating me like this? I didn't do it. I wasn't even there. My husband told me to say that.
You do everything it says.
He threatened me. How can I expect you to believe me? You can believe him. He's a cop.
Oh, give me a break. He's no cop. The man's got a rap sheet.
You have no idea what he's capable of. He did this to my son. I don't know what else he might do. Please, I need your help.
Oh, forget it, lady. I've seen it over and over. It was your job to protect your child. You're going to...
If you don't believe me, call the bank where I work. They'll tell you where I was. I wouldn't do this to my son!
Even if it's true, you're just as responsible, leaving your child with a man like that.
I didn't leave him!
Tell it to your lawyer.
I didn't leave him.
I love you, Alexander. Just remember what I told you.
Your son Ryan told doctors that it was your husband Nick who burned him. Is that true? Did your son tell the truth? Did Nick burn him?
No.
I have affidavits here from your place of employment that you were called home by your husband because of an accident to your son. Are you refuting that?
May I have a word with my client, Your Honor?
Yes.
I thought we agreed you would tell the truth. You know as well as I do that he'll post bail. Can you guarantee to me that he won't get to me or Ryan?
Your son will be taken away from you. Is that what you want?
I'll give him to my mother. I'll be safer with her.
And what about you? Counselor, does your client wish to change her statement? Very well, then. It seems obvious that you've been protecting your husband. I can't trust that you will not put your child at risk again. Therefore, I'm awarding temporary custody to your mother. Until such time, you can prove that he will be in a safe home. A court date will be set for you, sir, to answer the criminal charges brought against you. Until then, you are forbidden to go near the boy. Court is adjourned.
It's over. I did what you wanted. I lied for you.
Listen, you're my wife, all right? You're going to stand by me through this thing. The judge is going to see what a perfectly married couple...
No, no, you are not going to touch me, and you're going to stay away from my son.
You know, Alexander, if social services found out about your mother being, you know, damn near blind and everything, you take Ryan away in a heartbeat and put him in foster home. Is that what you want?
You can't do this to me.
No, I can't do this. Now you come home where you belong. I'll be back at 5. You have dinner ready.
I'll need to go to the market.
There's plenty of food in the freezer. And when I call, pick up the phone because I don't have to drive all the way back, all right? Alexander, you look like hell. Put on a little makeup. It'll make you feel better, all right?
Thank you.
son of a...
NYPD, 43rd Precinct.
Yes, I got a badge number. I need to know the officer that it belongs to.
Alexander, what are you doing?
I was just trying to figure out something to make for dinner. Oh, you were supposed to be home at 5.
I changed my mind. I missed you.
I'm in a very dangerous relationship. I need help.
Where are you? We'll send someone for you.
I'm at work.
You'll have to leave your job and anything else he can tie you to.
No, you don't understand. You see, I have a son and my mother's got custody. I can't leave them. But this man is capable of doing anything.
Just tell me where you are. Please, tell me where you are.
No. You can't go back to him.
Tell me how else am I going to
connect with him? He tracks me. He picks me up. He drops me up. He knows where I am every minute of the day.
You just have to get through this till they try him and pack him off to jail.
If they ever do.
It's just another abuse case.
Stop it.
Trust you, Alexandra. You're using that job to sneak off and do things behind my
job.
You're not leaving your job, huh? You don't need that job, okay? The job is in the way. You're gonna call and tell him it's over.
No.
No? No? Oh, hold it. Come here.
You're gonna call. You're gonna tell him that you're quitting. Do you understand me?
Please.
Do you understand me?
Do you understand me?
Do I make myself clear?
Yes. Okay.
That wasn't so difficult, was it? Better than that job. I want you here for me. Act like a wife.
I think I'm bleeding. Doctor.
You're always making things bigger than they are. It's a flesh wound. All right, let me see it. All right. You're gonna be okay. Rita, hi. Listen, I'm coming over. If I say I'm coming over, that means I'm coming over, okay? I'm coming over. And I love you. You know what? I'm going to spend the night with you, so you wear something really nice for me, all right? Okay? Okay. I love you too, Maria. I gotta go out for a few minutes. You look tired. Get some rest, sweetheart. Okay? All right.
Please, Mommy, stay with us.
Oh, honey, I can't. But we'll all
get together soon, I promise, okay?
I tried so hard to protect you when you were young. I wish I could protect you now.
It's okay. Okay. And look, you're gonna have to stay by his side every minute of the day.
I will,
okay?
You'll be all right.
All right, thank you. Goodbye, sweetie.
Take care.
Boy.
I'll just come by and see you and Ryan, okay? Is everything all right? You guys okay? Great. Kiss him goodnight for me, all right? All right, thanks, Ma. I gotta go. Bye.
Oh, wait a second. You forget to tell me the part where you're married?
Does it make a difference?
Yeah, it makes a difference. I mean, what do you think, that you can have me in your wife's bed?
Hey, doesn't matter. Forget about it.
No, look. I'm not into this. Maybe you can just get me those clothes you promised me and call me a cab, okay?
Yeah. What do you want? I'll call you a cab. Just dry your hair off a little bit.
I said stop it. I don't want your hands on me.
Hold on. I'm not going to hurt you. I just want you to stay with me.
I'll call my own cab.
Again?
How did you find me?
We have ways of doing that.
Is this about Jules?
No, not exactly. We've discovered another body and we'd like to discuss it with you.
Maybe we could talk about that.
That's all right. Have you ever seen this girl before? Because we got reason to believe that your husband knew her.
No, I don't know anything. I don't want anything to do with Nick anymore.
Look, this girl, Cheryl, is dead, strangled. 21 years old, she's beautiful. Dumped like so much flotsam up by the Hudson River Parkway.
Nick's paper number was in her purse. He says he never heard of her. That seems strange to you?
I mean, what are the odds your husband knows so many people like this are all murdered in the same way?
What are you talking
about me? Oh, I'm trying to tell you what.
You're my son, and he's still out there walking around. Are you going to lock him up?
Oh, right now he's not even a clear-cut suspect. We're digging right now. Miss Pagan, to be truthful, we need your help.
When he hurt Ryan, I came to you, and I tried to tell you people what kind of person Nick was. Nobody wanted to listen to me. Nobody. So now you want my help? I don't think so. I'd have to be crazy to expose my son again.
No one's asking you to expose him.
Do you have any idea what Nick did to Ryan? He scarred him for life. And I failed to protect him. Where were you? Nick's capable of this. But did you stop him? Are you going to stop him next time?
The hard truth of it is, there are no guarantees.
Yeah, well, the hard truth is that if you found me, Nick will find me, too.
Yeah, I need a cab at Bainbridge and Decatur as soon as possible, please.
That you didn't want me anymore. I'll give you a divorce, whatever you want.
Honey, Maria means nothing to me. I take care of her kids, that's all. You're my wife. You'll always be my wife, sweetheart.
past, honey.
You know what? This is what you need.
No, I already took some.
No, 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 it's okay. Come on, it'll help you sleep. Here you go. That's it. Good girl.
The label only says one.
One's good, two's better. Come on. Here you go. That's all right. Good girl. And I'll make you sleep like a baby, okay? Now, here we go. Lay down. Scoot down. Lift your head. That's it. Okay.
Morning, boys. What's up? You guys find that missing girl yet?
The thing is, she's not missing anymore. She's dead.
We're gonna have to go over a few more things.
Yeah, I told you all I know.
Yeah? What's going on?
Oh, nothing. Maria's kids were friendly with that little girl, that's all.
Yeah, well, we talked to Maria's kids again, and they say that Kitty was in the car with you just before she disappeared. How come you didn't mention that when we talked to you?
I saw Kitty at like 5 o'clock. There were a lot of other people that saw her after me.
That girl was in the car at 5 o'clock, and then she disappears at 5:30. We're gonna have to take a look at that car.
Well, just give us a few minutes to get ready, and we'll show it to you. Honey, get the guys something to eat.
Little Katie's death has brought this Bronx community together in a way rarely seen here.
We understand you have a personal stake in this vigil tonight.
Yeah, well, my own niece was taken and killed, and I think it's up to us in the neighborhood to do something about it. I mean, you know, it's ridiculous. I mean, the police obviously aren't doing anything.
So I can't relive this.
It's alarmed every parent in the neighborhood.
People are starting to say things, Nick. The neighborhood thinks you had something to do with this.
Come on, Joey. You know, I've been working with the police. And driving them around, showing her places she might hang out.
Yeah, and you ought to know better.
It's gossip. No. And they got reason to say these things. You knew every single one of those girls that's been killed. And it's right here. Even the paper is calling you the common denominator.
Joey, you believe what you read in the papers? Only morons believe what they read in the papers. Nikki is blood. And in this family, we stand behind blood. You understand?
Joey, this is crap. I mean, they gotta print something, so they print lies. I mean, look at this. Right here.
Just think about Cheryl. I never knew Cheryl. And, Katie? Well, Katie, you knew Katie as well as I knew Katie.
No, I never laid eyes on her, and you know it.
She's one of them that ran around with Maria's kid.
No, you're wrong.
You knew her. Think about
You're wrong.
You knew her.
You're always trying to twist things. You're wrong.
What am I twisting around?
You're twisting.
Joey, kid. Come back here. Come back here.
Hey, give me some sugar while you're out there.
He's a little tense. We all are.
Listen, does anyone in this room think I would touch a hair on Jules' head? My own niece? I mean, come on.
Of course not. That's not what he meant.
My boy is a good boy. Because the people want to feed on something, so they feed on him. But soon everything will be over, huh?
Right. That's right, Pop. Listen, everything will be over. They'll catch the guy and they'll be off the hook, all right?
Mm.
Okay. Hey, Joey, the sugar.
I'll get it.
He's crazy, man. He's always trying to twist things around. My whole life he's done stuff, and he just twists it, and he twists it.
Like what?
And I try to tell them, but they don't want to listen to me. Nah, Mickey's too perfect to do anything like that. I can't believe I looked up to him.
If you know something, please tell me. Joey, I live with him. I need to know.
When I was little, he raped my little cousin, okay? He locked me in a closet and he raped her. And then he's gonna try and convince me that it didn't happen, but I know it did. Because I could hear her screaming. And he did it because his mother left him with that sick old man in there.
They said she died.
Yeah. And the big family lie. And they just all want to pretend like it's all so normal.
It's time to go out, Jen.
Hey, gentlemen, what the hell's going on here? See this garbage in the press? You guys behind this?
What are you so hard for, Nick? It's the media. They have to print something. They never get it right.
Well, haven't I been cooperative from the beginning of this thing?
We're just trying to get it out the mesh, you know. Look, since you're here, you think we could ask you a few more questions to straighten some stuff out?
Yeah, of course. I mean, you know, like I said before, I got nothing to hide.
Sonny, do you mind getting Miss Pagan a coffee?
No. Miss Pagan stays with me.
Don't worry. Detective Cabrillo here will take good care of him. Come on.
So, I was right about you. You're still with him.
I need to talk to somebody.
You want anything? Coffee?
Oh, you boys ought to know me by now. I never put impurities in my body.
Oh, yeah, I forget. You know, I had to get myself on the program like that.
I've just got to get this straight.
Sit tight. We'll get to you.
You went home after we questioned you the night that Katie disappeared?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've been over this. I was with my wife.
You were there all night?
Yeah, I was there all evening. What's this about?
Well, see, we got a witness that puts you by the side of the road where Katie was dumped that same night.
Me? No, that's crazy. What time did he say it was?
1:30 a.m.
No, I was with my wife all evening.
Ask her.
Right.
Bring her in here and ask her.
That's what you're protecting, when you're protecting him.
I am not protecting him.
You lied when he burned your son. You stayed with a man who does that to people.
I love my son. He's 4 years old and I can't be with him. How do you think that makes me feel?
You made your choice.
Do you think I have a choice? I didn't have a choice.
Now, wait a minute. We still got business. We need to talk about Nick's alibi, the one he says you can provide for him.
What do you mean?
He says you were with him all night the night Katie disappeared. But a witness saw him at 1:30 by the Bronx River Parkway.
I don't know. He gave me too much cold medicine that night. I was dead to the world.
Maybe you want to say that to the mothers of these girls. This is something you just don't get over.
Don't you think I know that? Don't you think I want him locked up more than you do? He did this to me. He burned my baby. You're supposed to be protecting people from that. You want so badly to put this on me. On me! Well, you do your job. You get him off the street.
The DA's not buying the murder charges with what we've got now. That's why you need to tell me the truth. Was he there or wasn't he there with you that night?
I don't know. He could have slipped out. He has a way of making you think that things happened that didn't. He eats your mind.
All right. I want to go over things until we can find a shred of something to go on.
I do have something. The pants that the dead girl is wearing, they're mine. Nick says that he doesn't know her, but how else would she get them if he didn't give them to her?
You think you can identify them?
There's a stain.
So you do admit that Katie was in your car?
Look, we've been over this whole thing, all right? I was at the grocery. I saw Katie and Maria's daughter. They saw my car parked out in front. They jumped in my car. They wanted to tease me. They teased me. I drove them across the street. That's it.
Yeah, okay. But if she was there, how come our dogs found nothing in the car?
Because I told you, my cars are very immaculate. They get cleaned every day.
No, that's not going to erase the scent. Not less than 24 hours later.
You sure that you showed us the right car?
I showed you all my cars.
Yeah, all the cars but the right one. I want to know where that car is!
Hey, guys, if you don't believe me, that's fine, you know. But I don't need to take this kind of abuse, all right? Excuse me.
Listen.
Hey!
We know you did those girls. We got a witness. Gonna put you right there at the dump site that night.
I wasn't there. The guy's lying.
You stay here. You stay right here.
The property department tore the place apart. Pink pants are gone.
What?
They had them. There's a description, but somehow they got lost.
He's the devil. Things happen.
He doesn't have power you and I don't have. He trusts you, you can get to him.
He does have power over me. He drains your confidence. He sucks it up and then he uses it for himself.
Listen, we'll do our part. We're going to keep the pressure up. Maybe he'll crack, maybe he won't. But you want him off the street? You want your life back again? You want your son back?
Charge me. Otherwise, get off my case.
Nick, come sit down. Try to relax. I made you a nice dinner.
I can't relax. How can I relax when I'm being harassed like this? Cops crawling all over the place. You bastards think you can pressure me, huh?
Huh?
I'm press back.
Call my lawyer. You want an injunction, huh? Want me to get an injunction?
For what? Why'd you have to keep the streets safe from scum like you? I don't know about you, but I'm tired of visiting morgues. Vincent! Hey, what's it? That's police property.
I need to speak with Gabriel.
You want to I'll take you. Oh, shoot. I've been waiting for this. I've been absolutely waiting for it.
Come right here. Pick me up.
You gotta get rid of your damn cops. They're making him crazy.
We want him off balance.
Pretty boy!
Gonna blow it. I'm telling you, if you want me to do something here, you need to back off.
How about you switch the decaf, huh? I'll take the decaf and shove it down your throat.
We know what we're doing.
I am telling you, if you want me to nail him, you're gonna have to give me some room.
I tell you, I'm gonna take him.
Right here. Take me.
Do you know what you're asking?
I'm gonna bring that sucker in right now.
I know what I'm asking.
Shapiro's on the line. He's going nuts. Come on.
I gotta go.
God, they think I'm stupid. They'll see who's stupid.
I'm telling you, get out now.
Like hell. I'm staying.
Do you have any idea what you're doing to this woman?
I'm telling you, back off.
See that? Do that. Pack your stuff, we're leaving.
Where to?
Just get your stuff. know I could count on you. My sweet Alexandra. Mm-hmm. Alexandra, please don't do this to me, all right? I'm trying so hard to get back what we once had. Please, can you just help me out? Can you do something?
I want to get it back, too. We just have some stuff that we have to work out first.
What do we have to work out? We'll work out. Whatever you want to work out.
Nick, you once told me that you would never lie to me.
I don't lie to you.
That's exactly what you did.
I didn't lie to you. I told you I didn't lie, and I mean it.
You did. You told me that you didn't know Cheryl.
It's the papers that are... You know what? We've already talked about this, and I refuse to talk about it anymore.
I saw the pictures of the dead girls, Nick. The day you went to see the cops.
So they've been working on you?
No. I found them on my own. And I saw my pants on Cheryl's body.
Your pants?
And I want to know if you didn't know her, how
did they get there? What do you mean your pants? What are you talking about your pants?
Some pants. Some pink pants that I left at her house. She was wearing them, Nick.
Honey, come here. When you buy a pair of pants, you're not the only one they sell them to, okay?
No.
They sell 100 pair of pants like yours.
I know, but Nick, my pants had a stain on them. The pants that Cheryl was wearing had the same stain. And what am I supposed to think?
I can't believe this. I can't believe you're doing this to me. You know how I fight to see my own daughters?
I know.
I can't believe you're doing this to me, too.
Nick. I want to be able to trust you, I do.
You care.
But I know you're lying about the pants because I saw them myself. I just want to know why. You can tell me. You can tell me anything, honey. I need you to tell me the truth, Nick.
Well, it's hard to remember. I mean, maybe I gave them to her. Wait a minute. Wait, it's not what you think. Let me just explain, all right? She was just a friend of mine, that's all. I swear to you, okay? She had my beeper number, and she got caught in the rain, you know? So she called me to pick her up. She lost her keys or something, and I said I'd give her dry clothes. Listen, how do you tell your wife you brought someone to your house? I mean, I didn't kiss her. If I told you all this, wouldn't I tell you if I kissed her? I swear.
Maybe it's true then. What'd they say? You killed her.
Nikki, it's Joey. Listen, something bad happened.
I refuse to stand here and let these false accusations continue when my father's health is paying a terrible toll because of them. Now listen, I'm a businessman, okay? I love children. I mean, the worst day of my life was having to go down and identify my own niece's body in the morgue.
If you like kids so much, how come they end up dead all around you?
Yeah, what about that?
One question, please.
I'm the one who called this press conference, didn't I? I mean, if I was guilty, would I do something like that?
You didn't
that?
Answer the question.
Delta, excuse me, my father needs me.
Are there any mental
no,
elements
no
in the
comments.
Case?
Nicholas, you said you'd gone away.
No, I'm here now, Pop.
It's bad. It's very bad, Nicky.
You can make it. Be as strong like a bull.
Like a bull. If anything happens to me, you take care of the family.
What's going to happen to you, Papa?
You. Oh, my most beautiful, perfect thing. You know that. I loved you more than my own life. I loved you like no one else. More than your mother, even. More than her. Kiss your father,
Papa, please.
Kiss your father, Nicky. Kiss your father, Nicky.
Papa, don't do this.
Kiss your father. He loves you. He loves you.
Papa, please.
Kiss me, Nicky.
He did this to you.
Wait. Don't you say that.
He's a very sick old man.
Shut up. Don't you say that about my father.
Nicky, don't have to kill me like the others.
They had to die, Alexander.
They needed to die.
Nicky?
What's this? I love you like no one else, Alexander. How could you do this to me?
Those clothes you promised me and call me a cab, okay?
Yeah. What do you want? I'll call you a cab. just dry your hair off a little bit.
I said stop it. I don't want your hands on me.
Hold on. I'm not going to hurt you. I just want you to stay with me.
I'll call my own cab. How did you find me?
We have ways of doing that.
Is this about Jules?
No, not exactly. We've discovered another body and we'd like to discuss it with you.
Maybe we could talk over that.
That's all right. Have you ever seen this girl before? Because we got reason to believe that your husband knew her.
No, I don't know anything. I don't want anything to do with Nick anymore.
Look, this girl, Cheryl, is dead, strangled. 21 years old, she's beautiful. Dumped like so much flotsam up by the Hudson River Parkway.
Nick's paper number was in her purse. He says he never heard of her. That seems strange to you?
I mean, what are the odds your husband knows so many people like this are all murdered in the same way?
What are you talking
about? I'm trying to tell you what.
You burned my son and he's still out there walking around. Are you going to lock him up?
Oh, right now he's not even a clear-cut suspect. We're digging right now. Miss Pagan, to be truthful, we need your help.
When he hurt Ryan, I came to you and I tried to tell you people what kind of person Nick was. Nobody wanted to listen to me. Nobody. So now you want my help? I don't think so. I'd have to be crazy to expose my son again.
No one's asking you to expose him.
Do you have any idea what Nick did to Ryan? He scarred him for life. And I failed to protect him. Where were you? Nick's capable of this. But did you stop him? Are you going to stop him next time?
The hard truth of it is there are no guarantees.
Yeah, well, the hard truth is that if you found me, Nick will find me, too.
Yeah, I need a cab at Bainbridge and Decatur as soon as possible, please.
Did you think I couldn't find you?
Nick, I found out about Maria. I thought that you didn't want me anymore, right? I'll give you a divorce, whatever you want.
Honey. Maria means nothing to me. I take care of her kids, that's all. You're my wife. You'll always be my wife, sweetheart. You know what? This is what you need.
No, I already took some.
No, it's okay. Come on, I'll help you sleep. Here you go. That's it. Good girl.
The label only says one.
One's good, two's better. Come on. Here you go. Sorry. Good girl. And I'll make you sleep like a baby, okay? Scoot down. Lift your head. That's it. Okay. Go to sleep, sweetheart.
Good morning, boys. What's up? You guys find that missing girl yet?
The thing is, she's not missing anymore. She's dead.
We're going to have to go over a few more things.
Yeah, I told you all I know.
Yeah? What's going on?
Oh, nothing. Maria's kids were friendly with that little girl, that's all.
Yeah, well, we talked to Maria's kids again, and they say that Kitty was in the car with you just before she disappeared. How come you didn't mention that when we talked to you?
I saw Kitty at, like, I don't know, like 5 o'clock. There were a lot of other people that saw her after me.
That girl was in the car at 5 o'clock, and then she disappears at 5:30. We're going to have to take a look at that car.
Man, just give us a few minutes to get ready, and we'll show it to you. Honey, get the guys something to eat.
Little Katie's death has brought this Bronx community together in a way rarely seen here.
We understand you have a personal stake in this vigil tonight.
Yeah, well, my own niece was taken and killed, and I think it's up to us in the neighborhood to do something about it. I mean, you know, it's ridiculous. I mean, the police obviously aren't doing anything.
So I can't relive this.
It's alarmed every parent in the neighborhood.
People are starting to say things, Nick. The neighborhood thinks you had something to do with this.
Come on, Joey. You know, I've been working with the police. And driving them around, showing her places she might hang out.
Yeah, and you ought to know better.
It's gossip. No. They got reason to say these things. You knew every single one of those girls that's been killed. And it's right here. Even the paper is calling you the common denominator.
Joey, you believe what you read in the papers? Only morons believe what they read in the papers. Nikki is blood. And in this family, we stand behind blood. You understand?
Joey, this is crap. I mean, they gotta print something, so they print lies. I mean, look at this. Right here.
Just think about Cheryl. I never knew Cheryl. And Katie? Well, Katie, you knew Katie as well as I knew Katie.
No, I never laid eyes on her, and you know it.
She's one of them that ran around with Maria's kids.
No, you're wrong.
You knew her. Think about it.
You're wrong.
You knew her.
You're always trying to twist things. You're wrong.
What am I twisting around?
You're twisting.
Joey, kid. Come back here. Come back here.
Hey, give me some sugar while you're out there.
He's a little tense. We all are.
Listen, does anyone in this room think I would touch a hair on Jules' head? My own niece? I mean, come on.
Of course not. That's not what he meant.
My boy is a good boy. Because the people want to feed on something, so they feed on him. But soon everything will be over, huh?
Right. That's right, Pop. Listen, everything will be over. They'll catch the guy and they'll be off the hook, all right?
Mm.
Okay?
Hey, Joey, the sugar!
I'll get it.
He's crazy, man. He's always trying to twist things around. My whole life he's done stuff, and he just twists it, and he twists it.
Like what?
And I try to tell them, but they don't want to listen to me. Nah, Mickey's too perfect to do anything like that. I can't believe I looked up to him.
If you know something, please tell me. Joey, I live with him. I need to know.
When I was little, he raped my little cousin, okay? He locked me in a closet and he raped her. And then he's gonna try and convince me that it didn't happen, but I know it did. Because I could hear her screaming. And he did it because his mother left him with that sick old man in there.
They said she died.
Yeah. And the big family lie. And they just all want to pretend like it's all so normal.
Starting to go out, Jen.
Hey, gentlemen. What the hell's going on here? See this garbage in the press? You guys behind this?
What are you so hot for, Nick? It's the media. They have to print something. They never get it right.
Well, haven't I been cooperative from the beginning of this thing?
We're just trying to get it out the mesh, you know. Look, since you're here, you think we could ask you a few more questions to straighten some stuff out?
Yeah, of course. I mean, you know, like I said before, I got nothing to hide.
Sonny, do you mind getting Miss Pagan a coffee?
Sure. No. Miss Pagan stays with me.
Don't worry. Detective Cabrillo here will take good care of her. Come on.
So, I was right about you. You're still with him.
I need to talk to somebody.
You want anything? Coffee?
Oh, you boys ought to know me by now. I never put impurities in my body.
Oh, yeah, I forget. You know, I ought to get myself on the program like that.
I've just got to get this straight.
Sit tight. We'll get to you.
You went home after we questioned you the night that Katie disappeared?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've been over this. I was with my wife.
You were there all night?
Yeah, I was there all evening. What's this about?
Well, see, we got a witness that puts you by the side of the road where Katie was dumped that same night.
Me? No, that's crazy. What time did he say it was?
1:30 a.m.
No, I was with my wife all evening.
Ask her.
Right.
Bring her in here and ask her.
That's what you're protecting, when you're protecting him.
I am not protecting him.
You lied when he burned your son. You stayed with a man who does that to people.
I love my son. He's 4 years old and I can't be with him. How do you think that makes me feel?
You made your choice.
Do you think I have a choice? I didn't have a choice.
Now, wait a minute. We still got business. We need to talk about Nick's alibi, the one he says you can provide for him.
What do you mean?
He says you were with him all night the night Katie disappeared. But a witness saw him at 1:30 by the Bronx River Parkway.
I don't know. He gave me too much cold medicine that night. I was dead to the world.
Maybe you want to say that to the mothers of these girls. This is something you just don't get over.
Don't you think I know that? Don't you think I want him locked up more than you do? He did this to me. He burned my baby. You're supposed to be protecting people from that. You want so badly to put this on me. On me! Well, you do your job. You get him off the street.
The DA's not buying the murder charges with what we've got now. That's why you need to tell me the truth. Was he there or wasn't he there with you that night?
I don't know. He could have slipped out. What's he doing with you? He's supposed to be in school.
It's been a little accident. You have to come home.
Brian! What's wrong with him? What did you do?
What did I do? It was an accident.
Tell me, damn it!
He's back. I was giving him a bath.
Why would you give him a bath? He's supposed to be in... Oh, my God, Nick. How could you do this? He's just a child.
Listen, I wanted to see Alexander. You can't leave me.
What are you doing? Just sitting there. Call an ambulance.
I'll drive. It'll be fast.
Just hurry up.
Alexander, you're gonna have to tell him you were there.
You're crazy.
I told you it was an accident.
Nick, what are you doing? Keep driving.
listen to me, all right? You listen to me. Now, why should they believe me when you don't? I'm the stepfather. I refuse to go to jail over an accident that was not my fault.
Nick, please, he needs a doctor.
And admit it was your fault, Alexander. You should have been there. You should have been with us.
I'll do anything, please.
Don't screw me on this, Alexander. I got friends in authority. Here's bail. You put me away, and I'll be out in 48 hours, and I swear to you, I'll get you and I'll get you again.
I'll do anything, Nick, please. Please just get my son to a doctor. Please. Sweetie, they're gonna take care of you, okay? We'll slide here on this side. It's all right. I'm afraid I'm gonna have to ask you some questions.
No, I have to go with my son.
What
he
happened
here? He was burned.
It was an accident. My wife was bathing him, and our water's kind of unreliable.
You understand I'm gonna have to call in social services.
What? Social services?
Ryan's never even had a bruise before.
Ryan! Ryan!
The bad news is your husband's going to be arrested on charges of attempted murder. The good news is you're going with him.
Please, I want to call the hospital. I want to check on my son.
They can and will be held against you. If you, all this concern's coming kind of late, isn't it?
Why are you treating me like this? I didn't do it. I wasn't even there. My husband told me to say that.
You do everything Nick says.
He threatened me.
How can I expect you to believe me? You can believe him. He's a cop.
Oh, give me a break. He's no cop. The man's got a rap sheet.
You have no idea what he's capable of. He did this to my son. I don't know what else he might do. Please, I need your help.
Oh, forget it, lady. I've seen it over and over. It was your job to protect your child. You're going to...
If you don't believe me, call the bank where I work. They'll tell you where I was. I wouldn't do this to my son!
Even if it's true, you're just as responsible, leaving your child with a man.
I didn't leave him! I didn't leave him! I didn't leave him!
Tell it to your lawyer.
I didn't leave him.
I love you, Alexander. Just remember what I told you.
Your son Ryan told doctors that it was your husband Nick who burned him. Is that true? Did your son tell the truth? Did Nick burn him?
No.
I have affidavits here from your place of employment that you were called home by your husband because of an accident to your son. Are you refuting that?
May I have a word with my client, Your Honor?
Yes.
I thought we agreed you would tell the truth. You know as well as I do that he'll post bail. Can you guarantee to me that he won't get to me or to Ryan?
Your son will be taken away from you. Is that what you want?
They'll give him to my mother. I'll be safer with her.
And what about you? Counselor, does your client wish to change her statement? Very well, then. It seems obvious that you've been protecting your husband. I can't trust that you will not put your child at risk again. Therefore, I'm awarding temporary custody to your mother. Until such time, you can prove that he will be in a safe home. A court date will be set for you, sir, to answer the criminal charges brought against you. Until then, you are forbidden to go near the boy. Court is adjourned.
Alexander.
It's over. I did what you wanted. I lied to you.
Listen, you're my wife, all right? You're going to stand by me through this thing.
The judge is going to see what a perfectly married couple.
No, no, you are not going to touch me, and you're going to stay away from my son.
You know, Alexandra, if social services found out about your mother being, you know, damn near blind and everything, they'd take Ryan away in a heartbeat and put him in foster home. Is that what you want?
You can't do this to me.
Oh, no, I can't do this. Now you come home where you belong. Be back at 5. You have dinner ready.
I'll need to go to the market.
No, there's plenty of food in the freezer. When I call, pick up the phone because I don't have to drive all the way back, all right? Alexander, you look like hell. Put on a little makeup. It'll make you feel better, all right?
Trying to figure out something to make for dinner. But you were supposed to be home at 5.
I changed my mind. I missed you.
I'm in a very dangerous relationship. I need help.
Where are you? We'll send someone for you.
I'm at work.
You'll have to leave your job and anything else he can tie you to.
Well, you don't understand. You see, I have a son and my mother's got custody. I can't leave them. But this man is capable of doing anything.
Just tell me where you are. Please, tell me where you are.
No! You can't go back to him!
Tell me how else am I going to pick
him up? He picks me up. He drops me up. He knows where I am every minute of the day.
You just have to get through this till they try him and pack him off to jail.
If they ever do.
It's just another abuse case.
Stop it!
Alexandra, using that job to sneak off and do things behind my
job.
You're not leaving your job, huh? You don't need that job, okay? The job is in the way. You're gonna call and tell him it's over.
No.
No? Yes, no? Oh, hold it. Come here.
You're gonna call. You're gonna tell him that you're quitting. Do you understand me?
Please.
Do you understand me?
Do you understand me?
Do I make myself clear?
Yes.
Okay. That wasn't so difficult, was it? Better than that job. I want you here for me. Act like a wife.
I think I'm bleeding. Doctor.
You're always making things bigger than they are. It's a flesh wound. Right, let me see it. All right. You're gonna be okay. Ray, hi. Listen, I'm coming over. If I say I'm coming over, that means I'm coming over, okay? I'm coming over. I love you. You know what? I'm going to spend the night with you, so you wear something really nice for me, all right? Okay? Okay. I love you too, Maria. Bye. I gotta go out for a few minutes. You look tired. Get some rest, sweetheart. Okay? All right.
Every minute of the day, okay?
I will. You'll be all right.
All right, thank you. Goodbye, sweetie.
Take care.
Boy.
The part where you're married?
Does it make a difference?
Yeah, it makes a difference. I mean, what do you think, that you can have me in your wife's bed?
Mm. Doesn't matter. Forget about it.
No, look.
Brian? Brian, did you hear me? Brian, are you getting dressed?
In other news, reactions were mixed.
Come on, we can't be late for school again this week. I mean it. Time to brush your teeth. Now. It's not a monster at all, it's a Ryan. Come on, Ryan, honey, please, we're late. Can you walk a little bit faster for me, please? Look, Ryan, I'm sure that you'll feel better when you get to school and you see all your friends, okay? Well, Ryan, I guess I'm gonna have to go without you. Goodbye. Come on up. Oh, my gosh, you're getting big.
Alexandra, they found a body they think might be the missing girl. They're going to take her mother down to identify. I've got to go. She needs me.
Come on, we gotta go to school. Wait, 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 wait.
okay? All right, here you go. Oh, you don't need to put it on the top, I guess.
Hey, long time no see, Nicky.
Hey, Doc, how you doing there?
Good to see you. Alexandra, come, you're next. She's been my patient since she was a little girl.
Well, let me say hi to her at least. Hi, I'm Nick the guy.
Alexandra O'Hara.
It'll be 20 minutes before the next one. I'll give you a lift if you want.
Thanks.
That's what I... Hold on.
Let me call you back. Right.
No, it's what I do. I run a livery service. Okay? We're going that direction anyway.
It's okay, really. I'll wait for the next bus.
Right. Listen, no charge for you. Any friend of the docs is a friend of mine.
I really could use a lift. Okay. Very nice car you have.
I have a fleet of them. I run them out to gypsy drivers. I don't normally do my own driving, you know. The customer has to be pretty special.
Doc said you were a flirt.
He said that?
Mm-hmm.
He really said that?
He said that.
I don't think of myself that way. I consider myself a very sincere person. I was wondering, maybe we could get together sometime if you want.
Oh, I don't really date.
Thanks for the ride, though.
I thought you swore off Nan.
I did.
Maybe you want to lend that one to me. Nice car.
New World Federal. Alexandra.
Okay. This is Alexandra.
Hi, Alexandra. This is Nick Pagan.
Listen, I was wondering. You know, you said you didn't date. Does that mean you're married? Because you know, I didn't see a ring or anything.
Nick, I have a 4-year-old son.
Oh, that's great. I love kids.
With work, you know, I hardly have enough time with him as it is.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, it doesn't have to be a real date or anything. I mean, you know, like the three of us could go and just...
It'd be nice to see you again, that's all.
Don't forget, we have a deal. I don't think so. My divorce wasn't a lot of fun. I still need some time.
All right, well,
maybe I can, check back sometime or something.
Bye.
You didn't throw away an opportunity that won't come around again. Like giving him my number.
Want to go to the moon?
No.
No?
No.
It'd be fun. I could rent a spaceship and we could pack a lunch.
Hi. No, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm here. I just stopped thinking about you, so I'll come by and say hi.
How'd you find out where I live?
I have my ways.
Certainly are persistent.
I just felt like something clicked when I met you yesterday, and I meant what I said. When I told you I like kids, I have 2 daughters of my own. Stephanie and Gina. They're 7 and 9. She's 9.
What about your wife?
Well, my ex-wife. She took them off to Philadelphia. I don't get to see them as much as I'd like to.
This is Ryan, my son.
Hey, Ryan.
Hi.
Can we get a handshake? Hey, Ryan, you like horses? I have a horse in Van Cortlandt Park.
I like bugs.
You like bugs?
He's a little obsessed right now with anything six legs or more.
Yeah, well, who isn't? Listen, I know a great place to see bugs. Have you ever been to the Natural History Museum?
No.
I've seen a bribe exactly. Thought you'd like him.
Thank you.
No, 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 look at this, look at this.
Wow.
Is that cool or what? Now look, this guy has his ears in his front leg. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
You can?
Yeah.
And when he rubs his wings together, you know what happens?
What?
He sings. That's how he sings, by rubbing his wings together. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see that giant red parrot up there?
Yeah.
And then look, there's a smaller green one.
Oh, yeah. I want to go over there.
Okay, go ahead. What?
Yeah. I was thinking how lucky Ryan is to have such a great mother.
Well, he's the best thing in my life. Although sometimes I feel like I just, you know, I don't have enough to give.
What about his dad?
He's not around much. Do you have a great mom?
She died when I was young. My father tried hard to make it up.
Yeah. My father walked out.
That's something I swore I'd never do, abandon my family.
What about your marriage? Your kids?
We were young. She left me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Mommy! Mommy, Nick! Come and look at the giant bird!
Well, thank you. I had a really great time.
Well, I hope it's the beginning of a lot of really great times. Listen, there's something I want to tell you.
Oh, you don't have to tell me anything.
I work undercover. I had a really good time with you tonight, so I just wanted you to...
And then you lied about deliveries.
No, I don't lie. You were the one person I would never lie to. No, it's a good cover and brings in a nice income. I just had a really good time with you tonight, and I wanted you to know what you're getting into.
You must go out with a lot of women.
I've known a few, but you seem different to me. You seem so grounded, you know, so together. I mean, like most women don't have it together.
No, that's not the way I feel.
Well... No one should have to do it alone.
I'm not ready for this.
It's okay, I'm... We'll do it any way you want.
Okay.
Well, hope I can see you again.
That's the one bad. Come here. It's my beeper. So one bad thing about this job, it calls me away at some strange hours. I hope you can get used to that. Hello. Yeah, I'll be there in 15 minutes.
Some coffee before you go.
You're too good to be true.
Hmm.
fine, honey. Go to your room and play for a minute.
Put the knife down.
You scared me.
I'm sorry, I was just trying to show you how easy it is to break in.
Well, you didn't have to scare me.
Don't worry, I'm going to put new locks in.
For crying out loud.
Honey, I just want to impress upon you how much you need a man around here. Ryan!
God.
Come here, buddy. I'm glad I got you. Come here.
Did you learn how to break into apartments anyway?
Police Academy. Come here, sit down, Ryan. You ready for this? Close your eyes.
It's an ant farm.
Fine.
Look at that. That's fantastic.
And this is for you. Open it. So, yeah. You're a beautiful woman, Alexandra. You deserve to be surrounded by beautiful things.
Thank you.
Open it.
Oh, Nick, it's beautiful.
Try it on.
Right here?
Yeah. That's the beauty of this place. There's no one for miles around. Go back. Joey just called. I found Anna. She's dead.
Killed my baby.
What are you saying?
And him.
I loved her.
You loved her. She is dead in that box because you loved her.
No, don't say that. That's a lie.
Miss Flores, you're upset. Please watch what you're saying around my family.
Where is your shame? You call my baby in the night. You toy with her. You tell her she should disobey her mother.
Mrs. Flores, I will not allow you to speak this way, even in your pain. No one talks about my family this way.
No, I will say it. They killed her. They squeezed the life from her and they come here. They think they can mourn her. Get out. I can't stand to look at you. Get out of my sight.
All right. All right. We'll leave. She's grief-stricken. But we don't have to listen to this talk. Say pazza!
No, you are the one who is crazy. You will rot in hell for what you did.
She pick on you.
Why don't we know why me? I mean, a woman's desperate, you know.
I mean, if your kid was found murdered, wouldn't you grab it at any kind of butter?
Mother said that you called, right? Why would you call her?
You know what? We've been over this. I'm done with this conversation.
No, Nick, I want to finish it. And whenever things get hot, you leave. You always leave. I want to know if you called that girl like your mother said. I mean, she's saying that she's the electrician.
Did you take sides of that crazy old woman against me? Is that what's happening here?
I won't be it. I'll leave you so fast.
Fuck out of here and you'll never see your father's money again.
You can't hold me hostage to that, Nick. I won't live my life that way.
Listen, don't I take care of you? Don't you live better than you've ever lived before? I mean, look at me. Now listen, I'm sorry I hurt you. It's just that it hurts me so much that you don't believe me when I say things to you.
Let's talk about my father's money, Nick.
You'll get it. It's just tied up.
And my mother's money that you promised for her
operation.
You'll
get that, too. This is so stupid for us to fight like this. You want to know if I called that girl or not? Do you want to know if I called that girl? I did not call that girl. Okay? I mean, if there's any truth to this, don't you think the cops would be crawling all over us?
Well, maybe they leave you alone because you're one of them.
No, honey, it doesn't work like that. I'm sorry.
There's no way you can make things perfect with that kind of man. Did you know that? You do it their way, and then they change the rules.
I won't let it go on.
Go on. It used to make me heartsick to watch you wait on your father when you were young. Bring his newspaper, polish his shoes.
Him.
Yeah, you wanted him happy.
I wanted him home.
And you think you can hold on to Nick the same way?
He owes me money. As soon as I get it back, I'm leaving him.
That's his hold on you. You really believe that he's going to
pay
you
back? I'll get it back.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Alexandra.
Come on, Ryan. We got to go. Yeah. I'll call you, Mom.
This whole thing is making me crazy. All right, listen, cops come with baggage, all right? The pressure just spilled over. I made one little mistake. I swear to you, I will never hurt you again.
I thought I knew you.
I know you. You know me like no one ever knew me. Yes, you do. My life is a garbage dump out there. I don't want that part to touch you. I want us to build something good together.
How can I build something with you when I can't even trust you?
You can trust me. You can trust me.
Tell me you get my father's money back. I don't care about
it. I don't lie, okay? You'll get your father's money back. But things got to change around here, all right? Now, I want you to go pick up my kids with me in Philadelphia. I want the whole family there. Nice. Got it?
Hey, Joe. What are you doing? You'll be late for school.
You girls won't buy cigarettes for you.
We do lots of things, but we don't smoke.
Yeah? What kind of things do you girls do? When I get in the car, I'll give you a ride.
Okay.
You don't pay anything for them. They think you can just come and take them whenever you want.
I got court papers, Colleen. I'm doing my part.
It's always on your terms. You always get what you want.
It's okay.
This is last time. Do you hear me?
You're not going to... Colleen, you want to talk to my lawyer?
You seem like a nice lady. Take care of my girls for me, would you? You may not believe it, with his smooth charm and the way he surrounds himself with his family, but he's real dangerous.
Alexandra, let's go.
Don't cross him. Best thing that can happen to you is if he finds a new woman and moves on.
Oh, he's worried sick.
Jules isn't home yet. She hasn't even called.
Yeah, she's probably with that friend of hers and forgot about the time or something.
What do you want me to do, Nick? You know how it goes.
We can't find a missing person until she's gone 24 hours.
Oh, come on, Mario. So that's it with people you know? We gotta play it by the book?
This is my kid we're talking about.
Look, she was last seen at the school at 8:20 this morning. If she's not back by 8:20 tomorrow, then come in and file a complaint. You're not listening to me.
Hey.
Jules is not the kind of girl to run away.
Sir, we're doing everything we can, okay?
Nick, you gotta help me, man.
Mario.
You know what?
This time you come on, Nick. Just give me a break, man.
Street cops are morons. They draw the check and they don't do nothing. And listen, I'm gonna take care of this myself, okay, Ray? I got some friends, I'm gonna make a call. I'm gonna find her, alright?
But you gotta be my aunt in here, man.
Huh? You're gonna be okay.
I'm fine. Alright.
Get out of the way.
Okay.
Mr. Pagan.
Yeah.
Harold Shapiro, 43rd Precinct. You're the uncle, right?
Uh-huh.
I understand you were the last person to see the girl.
No, I was with my family all day. Pick up my daughters in Philadelphia. My wife is there asking.
What we're telling you is that we've got witnesses who put you with your niece at the school that morning.
Yeah, no, I caught her and her friend down by the corner grocery buying cigarettes. I kicked their butts and I sent them back to school.
You mind telling me why you didn't say anything to us about this before?
Well, maybe because nobody bothered to ask me before. But Mr. Shapiro, if you'd been on top of this thing the way you should, you know there was another witness that saw her get into a black van after school. You know, maybe if you check that out, you'd find her.
We'll do that.
Good.
Mr. Pagan, nice meeting you.
My pleasure.
Why don't you tell him you're a cop?
Can't go flashing my badge.
To another cop?
Now, Xander, shut up, okay? Shut up if you don't know what you're talking about, all right? Now, if I hadn't got through the commissioner's office, those two know-nothings wouldn't be on this thing at all.
Nick, answer my question.
What's your question?
Why didn't you tell them that you're a cop?
Listen, I'm in a dangerous position here, okay? I can't tell guys like that I'm a cop because... I'm in deep undercover right now. I investigate other cops.
NYPD, 43rd Precinct.
Yes, I've got a badge number. I need to know the officer that it belongs to.
Is there a complaint?
No, please, if you could just give me the name of the officer. The badge number is 6375.
All right, just a minute. Now, ma'am, where did you see this badge?
An officer showed it to me.
We'll need your name and address. We're going to send someone out.
No, no, don't do that.
Well, ma'am, in order for us to... Ma'am?
Well, Miss Pagan, is Nick here? Because we have to get a hold of him. They discovered another body. His brother's down at the morgue, and... he wants Nick to stand by him while he identifies it.
By the way, we checked out that black van, but we came up with nothing.
Listen, I hear you've been calling the department about me. I don't want to hear something like that ever again, you understand? And messing around with things you don't understand. Just keep your nose out of it.
She was found in a garbage bag by the Whitestone Bridge. She's been dead just about a week. Oh, God.
Ma, it's me. Listen, I gotta get out of here. Can we stay with you a while? Yeah, I got him in school. I'll bring him by.
Alexander. Who are you talking to?
My mother, she's sick. She needs me.
I know you, Alexander. You're lying to me. Bring her here if you have to.
This is the way I want it, Nick.
You regret this. Nobody leaves me.
This, I'm way over my head in debt as it is.
Yeah, this is the kind of place you should live in, all right? And don't worry about the money because I'm going to take care of you now.
No, I don't want to have to rely on you.
Don't rely on me. Listen, I want us to have things, okay? I want us to travel and see the world. Besides, it's a much better place for Ryan.
Wow. Never lived in a house before. I've always lived in apartments.
Well, now you can live in a house.
Hey, Joey, how you doing?
How you doing?
This is my nephew Joey. This is Alexandra and Ryan.
Hi, nice
give her a kiss.
You.
Give her a nice kiss. And this is Anna. Hi, Anna.
Hi.
This is Joey's girlfriend, Anna.
Hi, Anna.
Is she pretty?
I am beautiful.
Hey, you're finally here.
Hi. Nice
oh, so this is the one. Oh, and this must be Ryan.
Yeah,
hi. Hey, Alexandra. Hi.
Hi.
I think he told us all about you.
Hi,
but I can see
doing?
Already you're too good for him.
Hey,
this is my brother Ray
hi,
and
Ray.
Luisa, my
you.
Sister. And this is Jules, his daughter. Hey, Jules. How are you? Say hi.
Hi.
This is
Jules.
This is Miss Flores and Mr.
Ryan.
Flores.
Hi.
That's Anna's
hi.
Mother and father. Papa!
Don't worry, it's not as overwhelming
yeah.
as it seems.
And
this is my father.
Nicholas, my pride and joy. This boy is going to bring this family back to what it once was. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Well, Pop, what do you think of that?
She looks just like your mother.
Yeah, come here. I'll show you.
See, the profile? Right, Nikki? She was so young. All she ever wanted to do was visit relatives in the old country. The biggest mistake of my life was putting her on that boat. Alone.
Papa, please. Nobody wants to hear this. This is a happy occasion.
Right. Give Alexander a drink.
Come on.
Nikki. Hey, this girl, she really wants you.
This is what I want, Pop.
Yes, well, you've always gotten what you wanted. I saw to that, and I will continue to see to it.
Quiet down, everybody. I have an announcement to make. I brought Alexandra here today because I wanted you to meet the woman I've been looking for my whole life.
Oh.
The woman that I want to be my wife.
Oh.
That is it. She'll have me.
Oh, I don't believe this.
You gotta say yes. You don't want to embarrass me in front of my whole family.
Don't let him get away, Alexandra. He's a good man.
But be careful. You get him, you get his whole family.
Hey, Brian, come here. Listen, tell your mom to say yes.
Say yes.
Well?
Yes.
I want my son to be happy, and that's all I ever wanted.
Salute.
Salute. Cheers. Salute.
Salute. Congratulations.
Welcome to the family.
Bye, son.
Thank you.
I'll race you to the door. No, I'll race you. No, I'll race you. Oh.
Mom, it's us.
Now, were you a good boy at school?
I passed.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Go to the kitchen. There's a surprise. Oh. Ah, oh, he's a joy, that boy.
Yeah. Look, I got the wedding photos back.
Okay.
Here. Thank you, Nana.
That's all right, darling. This one's for you. What'd they say at the clinic about your eyes?
They want me to have the operation, but Medicare's not going to cover it.
Well, don't worry, I'm getting you the money.
You made a beautiful bride. Not twice, huh?
Ma, why can't you be happy for me? Just because your life didn't work out, it doesn't mean that mine can't. This time it's gonna be good. Very good.
Johnny!
Johnny! Hey, hey! I'm interrupting here.
Nick, why are you painting the place again? I thought you had it done before we moved in.
It wasn't right. I want it right. What's going on here? You giving your little girlfriend a hard time here, Joey?
I'm not giving her a hard time. Anyway, she's not my little girlfriend, right?
Well, everybody's saying how great you two are together. I mean, look at him, Alexander. Pretty sexy, huh? Look at these faces, huh? Of course, Joey's got a little growing up to do before he can handle a real woman, huh, Joe?
Hey, come on, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Listen, you guys are doing a terrific job. This place looks great. Here you go, pal. Take that out for something nice, okay? All right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Let's get this place cleaned up. Very good. Listen, I'm deep into a case right now, okay? Now, I'll get there when I can.
I'll get there when I can.
You know what? I'm not going to listen to this anymore.
Why?
Nick, what are you doing?
No, hey, listen, you know what? I'm hanging up now, okay? I'm hanging up. Goodbye. Now, I'm going over your bills here to see what you can consolidate.
It's 3 in the morning.
I know, honey. I'm kind of wired still. I had a late shift. Can you maybe make me some breakfast or something?
Sure.
Thank you.
Who are you talking to on the phone?
I don't know. One of the drivers. Alexander, what's this? It's got $21,000 in it.
Oh, it's my father's retirement fund. He thinks because I work in a bank, I should handle it for him.
This is crazy to keep this kind of money in the bank. You should invest it for him.
Yeah, I know. But it's the first time he's ever trusted me with anything important.
I realize that, but I mean, the guy's worked hard his whole life, right? I mean, at least you'd give him a shot at a decent retirement.
He's an old man in a nursing home. It's all he's got in the world.
Yeah, but we can make him a lot of money. Let me invest it for him.
I don't know.
Let me invest it for you. Okay? Honey, please.
Okay.
Okay?
she'll never leave me, okay?
Yeah, give me five. No, other side. Cut the pickle.
Nikki, I've been calling you all over. I called you here, I called your beeper. Why didn't you call me back?
Relax, I've been around. What's up?
Man, you gotta help me. I think something happened to Anna.
What do you mean? What happened?
Well, her mother's been calling, and I guess they had an argument the other night. And Anna said she's gonna go over to Gina's house, and Gina hasn't seen her. She hasn't called me. Nobody's seen or heard from her.
She'll turn up. Maybe she's over some other friend's house or something.
She would have called me first. I would have been the first one she'd have come to.
All right. I'll make a call to some friends I know, a missing person, see what's going on. Alexander, take Joey in and get him a cream soda or something.
Come on. Ryan, come on.
It's all right, Joey. We'll find her.
Now? How can you just stop looking for her?
So, honey, I've been all over the whole city on this thing. Eventually, she'll show up.
You know that?
Yeah, look, it fits a pattern with her. All right, she gets in a fight with her mother. She runs away, all right? It happens all the time.
No, that's not what Joey says.
Honey, I'm starting to crack here. All right, I just need a break from this damn city, that's all. The crime, all of it.
But, honey, you're a cop.
See, I'm up to my chin in it every day, you know? I mean, no matter how hard I try to shut it out, somehow it just leaks back in. You know, and there's nothing I can do to change anything. How do you think that makes me feel? You know, I'm just asking for a week, all right?
Well, I'm sure that my mother can take Ryan, but I don't have any more vacation time with her. I'd have to get an advance.
Just do it, okay? All right?
Yeah.
Love you. Mm-hmm. This place.
Where?
You'll see. I tell you or what? Is this a million miles away from the Bronx, huh?
It's beautiful.
You want a ride?
I'm not gonna fit on a horse.
Come on, you're fine. Oh. You're with me.
Okay.
Hold on. You all right?
Yeah.
You know, I never brought anyone up here before. I wanted you to be my very first.
You know how much I love you.
Mm, how much? What?
I have to hold on.
Hold on. Ready? Hold on. Whoa.
Wow. It's perfect.
No, not quite.